Hey folks, it's James, and I'm about to show you the design and presentation shortcut you might want to keep secret from your colleagues and competitors. Here's reality. These days, you have to present your design ideas quickly, but beautifully enough to engage clients and lead to decisions. The problem with hand sketches is that pencil and paper no longer cuts it today. The problem with 3D models is they only look presentable after too much detail, way too specific, way too early in design. So get out your iPads, download the free file I made during this video, and get ready to learn a workflow that presents ideas just as beautifully, maybe more, and in a fraction of the time of either sketches or 3D. So my friend Don Nesmith is a landscape architect who came to me and said, look, I really don't have time to do this rendering, but I have to sell this idea to this client. And I also did not have a lot of time, but we could put this much together for him in time for the meeting. So let me show you how we did that. And I will open up the video replay and we'll start here. And I'm going to just use my finger to slide back and forth. So the first stop, obviously, bring in the photograph. And we're probably going to have to expand the sides of the photograph. So the next step is to start and derive the perspective lines from that photograph and use the red pen to sketch the parallel lines that converge. And that gives me my vanishing point. And that's going to be important later when we estimate the sizes of things, okay? So the next step then is to bring in the drawings themselves. And what I do is I bring in that plan we looked at, but then I'm going to use the Move and Transform tool to flatten that plan and to bring it approximately down on the ground plane of the backyard. And that's going to give me my horizontal and depth directions for this design that we're going to sketch over this. And that combined with the perspective assist is going to make it possible to draw over this without any great skill in perspective, but just using the drawing assist feature in Procreate. So there's that plan again, and that's laying down pretty good. Now the next step is to do some crude lines and get warmed up with the drawing I'm about to make. So I like to just run the pencil around a little bit and just get the hand and the mind working together. And that's actually a kind of a meditative process, which is I'm asking myself, well, what's the next step going to be here? And then sure enough, I realize that the next step needs to be to bring in the section. So I bring in the section because I want to see what that cut's going to be like across the backyard. So I'm going to the section for the dimensions there and memorizing those and then bringing them back to my sketch. And here you can see me starting to lay out the section freehand at first, because it's just so much easier to think that way, and then quickly to switch over to the perspective drawing assist. Now, there was a shift in the plan there because I realized I was just too small across the backyard, and we're working fast, so we're estimating these things. So I need to stretch that plan, and you can see that here. And once that's stretched, I can reliably construct the section over that in perspective, because remember, I'm using drawing assist to help me construct the actual design here. And so I'll continue with that. And I'm just going to make a red box in the simplest form possible. And this isn't the rendering yet. This is just a sort of descriptive diagram of the design. But all of this is then drawing assist going off to that vanishing point that we located earlier on in the process when we diagram the perspective of the existing photo. So I can later convert these lines. You can see here that I've been erasing lines all along too, and that's because I'm erasing my construction lines, and I'm just trying to make things simple and not overly fussy. So as we progress, I start to frame the drawing, which kind of controls the part that I need to do. Now this was an interesting part here. You'll see me stretch out some of these things. I'll just copy and paste them. In this case, I'm using the clone tool to bring this wall forward just to see what that effect would be to stretch the perspective. And over here, I'm doing the same thing with the house. And then I set my final limits of the perspective at that point, because I know I want to see at least as much of the pool as this and of as much of the house as this to show them the relationship to that family room door. So now I'm applying a color below that sketch so I can see the major design pieces all at once all of a sudden, so I can begin calculating in my head what's left to do. Now I'm even putting in the large color areas too, the pool, and starting to experiment with what the plantings would look like on this side. Now this is, believe it or not, the turpentine brush here, It's one of my favorite ways of creating sort of a naturalistic, organic-looking vegetation that's not really specific yet, but just solid vegetation. And here we're building up the back there, and I'm putting these highlights of these green trees in. And all of this is still with a turpentine brush, which I'll show you all about in a later video. Then I'm completing the sky here. And notice how it's photographic, what the brushes in Procreate are allowing me to do. So it's very much a digital drawing as well as a hand-built drawing. And that's key. Now over here, we just add some color, and these are all in new layers, so we can control these colors later. We add colors for the underside of the soffit and for the rest of the house. And now we add the big color for the floor of the patio. And I'm starting to work up. There's no particular method to this. I'm just going piece by piece so I can get everything up to speed at the same level. So now I've finished the basic planting there, and I'm starting to add more detail in the foreground that I realize to cover up this photograph completely. And this is also a component of the design, this stepping up. And there, sure enough, you can see me bringing back the plan to remember what was involved. And we're down here in this corner, that down arrow showing the stairs that are going up. So here come those stairs, and there's the planter next to it. And again, all of this is in the perspective drawing assist back on that layer that we created that had drawing assist activated. All of these organic fields will become two or maybe even three layers to quickly simulate that same effect of these layered trees in the photograph. So here I am again adding the first layer, and then under that adding some black. I'll know I'll need that later. And I'm bringing back these colors. Now remember I said you can adjust these colors later if they're on their own layer. So here you see me adjusting these colors in just one fell swoop as I continue testing the pieces and testing the composition. And I realized that the pool color should be on top of the line drawing. So I moved that layer on top, and now you can see the line drawing looks like it's being seen through water. And let's see what else is going on here. Now we're in the cleanup phase. The cleanup of the overall composition, and I'm blocking in the final colors before we start adding details. Now we're adding the details, okay? So again, all new layers, and this will be the fieldstone detail all across this, and suddenly that is dramatically changed from when it used to be concrete. And this is something you can be guided by a image you find on the internet that shows you how fieldstone walls are made, or how this one wants to be made. Now my favorite part, adding shadows. I use the selection tool to create this entire selection and then fill it all in at once in multiply blend mode so that the shadow reveals all of the detail under it. And now the same over here. This gets a single layer of shade and shadow at the same time. And these little gestures here are all made by hand. That's creating the shadow cast by these plants. But you can see in multiply blend mode, all of these details still come through. Now watch the shadow being applied over the pool, and then multiply blend mode makes it look like it's actually down under the water. And here's the shadow for this vegetation, all done using the selection tool in freehand mode. And then starting to add some of the blooms and things. Experimenting with different brushes inside Procreate, all those brushes that are so confusing. And these blooms take me back to that public broadcasting show, Bob Ross, where it's really the brushes doing the work. I just need to know how big to make the brush and where to push it. But the brushes themselves are doing the work here. And you can see that appears in this distant little planting patch and this distant patch. And these are unchanged since we first blocked them in, but just that addition of plants and blooms really transformed them. And even back here, you can see some blooms. And now we're going to put in some entourage, and I'll put in this woman here. Now she comes in at full scale, and then we shrink her down, and that's in an image found on the internet, basically. And then we shrink her down, and we even add shadow to her, as you can see, if you look way back in there. And there's our finished rendering. And if I show you some of this detail here, here's that turpentine brush, as amazing as that seems. And you can see how it kind of begins to copy the same way that trees actually grow. And here are those blooms. They barely look like anything, and yet they work at a distance. And these tiny little blooms in the back. And again, you can see these random shadows that I created, basically making it look like this foliage was casting that shadow and shadows coming down the walls. And that's how you can do a quick rendering, much faster than trying to use keyboard and mouse, and much more digital and sort of modern than a hand drawing alone. Don't forget to download the free file that comes with this video. You'll find the link in the description below. If you love this kind of walkthrough, be sure to watch the next video. It dives deeper into fast rendering, so you don't need to stay up late, and you can still get ideas across in the most charming way possible.